Embattled Philippine Police Chief Oscar Albayalde not stepping down but ready to be fired over the drug recycling scandal hounding the country's police force. Two Filipinos confirmed to be among the fatalities after a bridge collapsed in Taiwan. Another Filipino remains missing. And Manila fires yet another diplomatic protest against Beijing, this time over the unannounced passage of Chinese ships in Ayungin Shoal. Good afternoon. I'm Carmina Constantino. Dateline Philippines begins right now. Welcome to the program. Philippine Police Chief Oscar Albayalde is keeping his post for now, despite being linked to rogue police officers who resell seized narcotics. That's as President Duterte says he will wait for the results of the Senate investigation on the drug recycling scandal before deciding on Albayalde's fate. Speaking to reporters before leaving for Russia, Duterte said once the hearings are done, he will forward the Senate report to the Department of the Interior and local government, which oversees the Philippine National Police.
But procedural due process must be followed. I cannot just wait for the Senate, its report, then adopt it as my own. Okay, bayan.
Sir.
Walang sanction kasi ang Senate. But when I decide on the basis of the report of Secretary Anyo, I can dismiss, discharge, terminate any and all of them. So hintayin ko yan. But we will be fair.
Duterte declined to answer questions on whether he has already lost confidence in Albayalde.
I would not preempt Secretary Anyo, but I leave it to him to decide. But the only thing was that if you really want to know, this does not bind Secretary Anyo of what might be his conclusion. He was, Albayalde was, happened to be the provincial police director at that time. If it comes to a serious thing as dismissing a top official here and there, it has to be for a good reason and there must be enough proof.
As for Police Chief Albayalde, he tells us he's not stepping down. Albayalde also hitting back hard at his accuser, former CIDG Director Benjamin Magalong.
As I've always said, I'm expendable. I'm expendable. I always considered myself as expendable. I'm fine. I'm okay.
Hounded by allegations linking him to rogue police officers, Philippine Police Chief Oscar Albayalde is making it clear he's ready to be relieved from his post. Albayalde has been dragged into a drug recycling scandal by former senior police official, now Baguio City Mayor Benjamin Magalong. Albayalde says he doesn't know why, but the police chief has a lot to say against Magalong.
I think this guy is really trying to portray himself as a man of integrity. That's all.
Would you call him a man of integrity?
Definitely not. Definitely not. No.
Is it because of what he's doing right now?
No. Even when he was in the active service, I'm sure. And I'm sure most of the people that he worked with would probably say same thing.
Asked about his previous encounters with Magalong, there was one time Albayalde says that Magalong had sought his help.
Way back 2010 or 2011, when he was made to float from 2006 to 2010, and one time he called me for a little favor. Mm. So now he's saying that a call is a bad thing. I favorably agreed to the call, to his request.
And his request was to
give him an appointment to the deputy chief, for administration then.
Mm.
General Rafanan. Mm. And General Rafanan can attest that. Then later, he was able to go back in the mainstream of the Philippine National Police.
Albayalde now turning the tables on Magalong.
We go back to the ninja cops. When did this ninja cops strive, Carmina? Is it during the time of Senator Bato when he was the chief, or during our time, or during their time? let me ask you that. He was the director of CIDG then. May I ask again, what were his accomplishments against these illegal drugs, against these ninja cops, and against those people that are under watch list? What I cannot understand really, Carmina, is how a single person can do this, you know? Especially so now that you're a mayor, where you're supposed to be a part of this government, no? A part of this government in the effort in ridding the nation of illegal drugs. If you're trying to say that you are a man of integrity, this is the right time that you can prove yourself that you are indeed a man of integrity. This is the right time to shine. This is the time to shine, not on destroying somebody's reputation.
Albayalde, who's set to retire next month, thinks the allegations against him are politically motivated. But while he considers himself expendable, the police chief says he's not stepping down.
Mayor Magalong said openly that he was so frustrated when President Duterte appointed me as the chief. Why didn't he tell it to the president then?
Are you willing to step down and go on early retirement? Because yun din ang pinag-uusapan. Kasama ba sa usapan yung, sige na lang, let me step down as top-ranking general?
What I see is that's their endgame. I will not fall in that trap, Carmina.
So you're gonna.
I will ask the president for that. I will wait for the president's decision, and I will wait for Secretary Anyo's decision. I think this is all about that, what you're saying now. This is all about that, what you're saying now.
President Duterte playing down a proposal of two U.S. senators to ban the entry of Philippine government officials involved in the detention of opposition Senator Laila de Lima. Duterte says he does not consider the proposal an interference into Philippine domestic affairs yet, as it has only been passed at the committee level. The ban was proposed last week by U.S. Senators Dick Durbin and Patrick Leahy. Both are calling for the release of de Lima, who has been detained since 2017 on drug-related charges.
I do not deal individually with the congressmen or senators there. It is not an act of state. It does not carry the mandate of the entire Senate. So if there is one or two or three who says that these things exist in the Philippines, let them. I cannot help them in their ignorance.
Duterte says he'll only raise the matter with U.S. President Trump or the U.S. State Department if the proposed ban passes the U.S. Senate. Duterte spokesperson Salvador Panelo earlier said the travel ban was a brazen attempt to intrude into Manila's internal affairs. Two Filipinos confirmed to be among the fatalities in the bridge collapse on Taiwan's east coast. The Manila Economic and Cultural Office in Taiwan says the Filipinos are among three bodies already retrieved from the site. Three more are missing, one of them a Filipino.
Their identities have been confirmed. I think the process of notifying the family is underway, and their bodies are now in a local mortuary in Ilan. After we have notified their next of kin, we will assist if the family would like to go to Taiwan and see their family member for the last time.
The bridge collapsed Tuesday, burying boats underneath. About a dozen people were hurt, including six Filipinos. The cause of the tragedy has yet to be determined. The Philippines firing off yet another diplomatic protest against China. Manila's top diplomat ordered the filing of the protest on Twitter over the unannounced passage of Chinese ships in Ayungin Shoal in the West Philippine Sea. The sighting of Chinese vessels in Philippine waters have made headlines in recent months, fueling the maritime dispute between Manila and Beijing. China has repeatedly ignored the Hague ruling that junked its sweeping claims in the South China Sea. On to some sports action now. The rest of the NBA better be ready because the Greek Freak is looking to improve his game from downtown. Reigning MVP Giannis Antetokounmpo has been taking three-point lessons from one of the league's greatest shooters, new teammate Kyle Korver. Korver. Korver ranks fourth all-time in three-pointers made in the NBA and has shot 42.9% from downtown in his career. Antetokounmpo has said he's working on his jump shot mechanics to make him an even better player. American Noah Lyles bags the gold in the 200 meters competition at the World Championships in Doha. Lyles, who had dyed his hair silver after a heroic anime character, took first place with a time of 19.83 seconds. Canada's Andre DeGrasse had, or the Rio Olympic silver medalist behind Usain Bolt, placed second again with a time of 19.95, while Ecuador's Alex Quiñones took the bronze. Lyles is expected to bring home more medals in the ongoing competition. A Filipino-American golfer from the Bay Area has made his professional debut. Out of more than 60 competitors, Isaiah Celinda from South San Francisco came in at 33rd place during the Safeway Open in Napa, California last week. Before turning pro, Celinda represented the U.S. in the Walker Cup against other leading amateur golfers from Great Britain and Ireland last month. Celinda also played for Stanford University from 2016 to 2019. Some entertainment news now. The Duchess of Sussex suing a British newspaper for publishing a personal letter she wrote. Meghan Markle's lawyers claim the publication was part of a broader tabloid campaign to publish false and derogatory stories about her and her husband, Britain's Prince Harry. No details about the letter in question were given, but Prince Harry, in a statement, classified the issue as bullying by some sections of the press. Harry also said he feared history repeating itself, referencing the 1997 death of his mother, Princess Diana, who died in a car crash while escaping the paparazzi. Well, the first photos have finally emerged from the day Justin Bieber married Hailey Baldwin for the second time. The 25-year-old pop star shared online some close-up snaps from the big day. In the caption, Bieber said he's looking forward to forever with his bride. The celebrity couple exchanged vows September 30 in Bluffton, South Carolina. They first tied the knot September last year in a secret courthouse ceremony in New York. Dwayne The Rock Johnson is returning to the ring. The Hollywood star confirms he's cooking up his appearance for World Wrestling Entertainment's SmackDown Live premiere. WWE also says other Hall of Famers would appear in that program. Johnson originally retired from professional wrestling in 2004 before coming back to fight John Cena in 2012 and 2013. And that's today's online edition of Dateline Philippines. Thank you for joining us. I'm Carmina Constantino. Don't forget to like and share this video and leave your comments below.